Hello everybody. Today we will be discussing about principles of mass transfer. We will discuss introduction to mass transfer and diffusion, similarity between heat, mass, momentum, transfer process. So while in introduction, if we start with introduction process, we find that various separation processes have certain basic principles which can be classified as fundamental transport function. That is, there is momentum transfer. There is mass transfer and there is heat transfer. So what we find is that the fundamental process of momentum transfer occurs in such operations such as heat flow, mixing, sedimentation and filtration. The heat transfer occurs in conductive and convective transfer, heat evaporation, distillation and drying. In a similar fashion, the third fundamental transfer process such as mass transfer, this mass transfer occurs in distillation, we are having in distillation, evaporation, ionization, liquid-liquid extraction, adsorption, crystallization and membrane processes. So it is occurs in distillation, absorption, we are having absorption there, membrane separation, etc. So, when mass is being transferred from one distinct phase to another or to a single phase, the basic mechanisms are the same, whether the phase is a gas, liquid or solid. This also exists for heat transfer, where the transfer of heat by conduction is followed by Fourier law in gas, solid or liquid. In general, we will now discuss general molecular transport equations. We now discuss here general molecular transport equations. For instance, all three molecular transport processes such as momentum, heat and mass are characterized by the same general type of equation. What is that? That is, rate of a transfer process can be written as the fraction of driving force per unit resistance divided by resistance. So what is that? In molecular transport of mass transfer, it is similarly in molecular transport of heat transfer or momentum transfer, in a transfer process in general, there should be a driving force and then to overcome the resistance. So what is the driving force? In case of mass transfer, that is concentration difference or concentration drop. Suppose at point 1, I am having C1 concentration, at point 2, I am having C2 concentration in point 2. There should be C1 should be greater than C2 or C2 or C2 should be greater than C1. So for transfer process to occur, these conditions must be satisfied. If both the points have the same concentration, then there will be no mass transfer. Actually, there is no gradient there. So there should be a gradient so that the mass flux can flow from one point to another point. That is by molecular transport. So, saying that, after this can be written for molecular diffusion of the property for momentum, heat and mass, it bears an analogy and can be written for molecular diffusion. Same this equation, the above equation, can be written for molecular diffusion. What is that? We see now. So this is psi z, that is flux, mass flux is equal to minus delta. Now we are having d gamma, right, dz. So gamma, d gamma is our, what is it? This is our concentration gradient or concentration drop. You can call it concentration gradient or drop. You can call it a concentration gradient. So this denotes the difference in concentration, which is actually allowing to overcome this resistance. Resistance in the form of different spatial dimension or path. So this concentration difference drives the mass flux to go from path z1 to z2. This d tau, d gamma. Saying that, now we do a simple equation for our Q. Suppose there is a Q. See, there is a Q here. Now, the shaded face, this face and this face. Now, assume that mass flux psi z at z enters in this Q. This is inlet. And again, it exits at psi z at z plus delta z. This is z and this is z plus delta z. For this condition, if we write a general balance equation, what is the balance equation here? Rate of mass in minus rate of mass out. Rate of mass generation minus rate of mass consumption equal to the mass accumulation, rate of mass accumulation, rate of mass accumulation. So, do we have mass generation here? We are assuming there is no mass generation, so this becomes zero. No mass consumption, if there is no mass consumption, this becomes zero. So what we are left with is that rate of mass in minus rate of mass out is equal to rate of mass accumulation. If the process occurs at steady state, suppose let there be mass generation term, let this be not be zero, this may be, this be R. So what will happen? We can write the same as this psi z enters from this hashed face. This is, let it be z direction, z direction, this be y direction, and this be x direction, something like that. Okay. Now the psi z enters to the yx plane, this hashed yx plane. So we can write, and this has unit dimensions, suppose it has unit dimensions, we can write psi z rate of mass in as psi z into 1. So this denotes the amount of mass entering through this shaded surface through the yx plane. So this is through the yx plane at z. This point is at z, this is entering through z. Again, we can write psi z at z plus delta z into 1, that is the cross section area of this space, my plus rate of mass generation, let there be mass generation R. So there, if there is no mass consumption, we can write it as 0, and then we have rate of mass accumulation. So we are having B gamma by Bt to delta z to 1. So this is rate of accumulation of property, or better write it as partial derivative. So this is rate of mass accumulation. So we now divide by both sides by delta z dividing both sides by delta z and taking delta z limit tending to 0 or delta z limit tending to 0, we get del psi z by del z plus del gamma by del t equal to r. Okay. Now we can now replace this psi z from equation number 1. Let this be equation number 1. We can replace this psi z term in equation number 2. This is our equation 2. Replacing the value of psi z from 1 in 2, what we get? We get minus del del square gamma by del t square plus del gamma by del t equal to r. So this is the case when there is no generation, when there is no mass generation source there, so we can, our equation becomes this. So this equation basically is dependent upon tau, delta tau. So our gamma or the concentration change depends on t, or this being denotes, this denotes in as steady state. So if there is no generation, no mass generation to be precise, then our equation will become minus delta del square gamma by del v square equal to minus of del gamma by del t. This cancels out. So this is the equation for, this is the unsteady state mass transfer equation. This is unsteady state unsteady state because your property gamma is varying with respect to time, it is not constant. That's why it's called to be unsteady state. It's said to be unsteady state. Now, as we saw here, that molecular diffusion, this is a molecular diffusion equation for mass transfer. So, molecular diffusion equation for momentum, heat, and mass, Newton's equation for momentum transfer for constant density also bears the same kind of relationship. What is that? That is, if we see tau zx is equal to minus mu by rho zx, minus mu by rho dvx rho by dz. So if you compare this equation with this psi z is equal to minus delta d gamma by dz, you find a similar kind of relationship where it denotes rate of transfer process, where it is diffusivity constant analogous to this, and we are having another term, that is d gamma by dz, driving force by resistance. Here also driving force by resistance. So tau zx is actually the momentum transfer, the momentum transfer into divided by meters per second. E by rho is here kinematic viscosity, and in meters per second, that is the distance, rho is the momentum, which has a unit of kg into meter divided by second. After that, this being said, we are having the equation for molecular diffusion of mass, Fick's law, which is written as follows. So, Fick's first law for diffusion of for mass transfer is written as JAZ equal to minus dAB del CA by del D. Sorry, for complete time derivative. Minus dAB dCA by dZ. So, J is the molar flux of component A. What is J? JZ is the, rather to make it a J Z star. Y star, I am coming to that. star is due to the fact that it is denoting the equilibrium, at equilibrium condition, what is the flux. A is Z star is molar flux of component A in the V direction. We are having DAB as the diffusivity, our DAB is the diffusivity, molecular diffusivity. PAB is the molecular diffusivity of species A in B, of A in B. So, how easily the molecule can diffuse it, how easily can molecule of A can penetrate in B is given by DAB, which has unit of meter square per second. J is it, has a unit of kg mole A by divided by second into meter square. So, what is its unit? J is it has units of kg mole A divided by second into meter square. Now we are having dCa by dz, as you know, dCa means concentration. So it has having units of kg mole per meter cube, and d has units of in meter. So c has units in kg mole per meter cube, and c has having units in meter. As we see here, the transport properties mu by rho, alpha and dAb all have units of meter square per second, and the concentration are represented by momentum per minute per unit meter cube divided by unit per meter cube, kg mole per meter cube. This will be continued in our next video, where we will be discussing turbulent diffusion equation for momentum and mass transfer. Thanks.